Hi, this is Bruce in Largs again. I don't have much to show in progress in the shed today. There's a little bit of cleaning up and trimming of bits, getting ready for assembly. But what I am going to try to show is the resurrection of an old business in miniature. My father was a foundry man. He owned his own non-ferrous foundry in Port Adelaide called Moffat's Foundry, and today I'm going to be trying to cast some lead into the centreboard pocket. And here is my makeshift kiln. It's bits and pieces out of a barbecue. The bricks are not refractory bricks, and hence they will in all likelihood crack. Maybe even go bang as they heat up. There's a fair bit of moisture in them, but so long as that's expected and we can deal with it and we've got safety precautions around it, that'll be fine. The idea is to melt the lead over a briquette fire in here. You can probably see if I take this out, there is actually a draft channel all the way underneath to draw air in, help the combustion get nice and hot. There are bricks around the perimeter to try to keep the heat that is generated up to a Dutch oven type saucepan that will sit on the top. And this strongback frame that's sitting here was going to be used, may still be used one day, as the strongback to build a Caledonia yawl. Today it's going to be used as a nice flat level platform to put the bits of the centreboard on while I cast some lead into it. So we'll see how we go. So the kiln has now been completed and the fire's been lit. Firelight is underneath two nice big stacks of briquettes. It'll be probably a half an hour before all of the briquettes are alight and really starting to roar. So we're going to leave this to its own devices for a little while and come back and make it happen. Now we're starting to see a little bit of action. We've got the kiln, we've got some briquettes starting to take on, we've got some lead ingots in a stainless steel pan, and I'm about to stack up some more bricks around the top to cut down the draft on the sides of the stainless steel pan, because they'll tend to cool down, which we don't want to happen. And I'm off at foundry, trundling along. Just moved the lid aside so that you can see that the first little bit of melt is happening. Down the bottom there, I've got a couple of lead sinkers just to start the process going. Once the lead starts to melt, I can get the end of the ingots into the molten lead, and that helps the transmission of the heat up into the metal, and once it starts to go, it'll go. We want this to be just over the melting point of lead. We don't want it to get really, really hot. I've started preparing the mould. This is very bright here, but you might be able to see. I've actually got three pieces of plywood that make up the centreboard. There's one side, and what we're looking at here is a fairly narrow central piece, which has a window cut out of it, the shape of the ingot that we're going to pour, and underneath that is the other side. And I'm about to line that window with thick aluminium sheet, actually a piece of a roasting pan that goes into an oven. So aluminium's melting point is quite a bit higher than lead's. So long as you don't get the lead too hot, we shall be all sweet. And coming back over to the shooting works, you can see while I've been talking, a second of the two lead fishing sinkers is melting before our eyes, and I'm going to step back now in case there's any residual moisture down in the bottom there anywhere, or any impurities that might spit. Well, we've just done the pour. You can see there's the kiln. All the briquettes still glowing away madly. I ended up having to use a propane torch to add energy to it. Here is the casting. The little plywood strips around the edge are just a dam for catching an overflow should one occur. And hopefully there won't be too much shrinkage back down as it cools. Hopefully that comes in pretty close to 8 kilograms because I don't have to do this again. Took a fair bit of time. There's the pot that I used to melt the lead in, and a little propane gun and a lighter. Some water in case I needed it. I've also got a hose on standby in case I needed it. Tiny little bit of scraps of lead drips coming back this way, but didn't waste too much, I don't think. And in here, this is you can see it's still slightly liquid. That's the surplus. I've got an ingot now cooling in a little aluminium tray, which I'll try to extricate later. So there's probably a day's work. It's an awful lot of day's work in building a boat, but there's one of them, the lead ballast for the centreboard.